Hey, what is going on, guys? Clickwood here, back again, bringing you guys a brand new series here on my channel. This time, we are going to be playing MLB 15 The Show. Now, if you guys are new to my channel, you probably don't know this, but I actually did not start playing Madden as the first game that I uploaded to my channel. The very first game that I actually uploaded was indeed MLB 13 The Show. Now, I know what you guys are probably thinking, why not MLB 14? Well, I actually did upload a couple of videos of MLB 14, but the problem is that that game was probably the glitchiest game that I've ever played online, and it just completely ruined it for me. I couldn't stand playing it. It was not any fun, but wanted to bring you guys a brand new series here on the channel and play MLB 15 The Show, because I've heard that they fixed a lot of the stuff that was a problem in MLB 14. So we are going to be playing a road to the show, like I said, a shortstop. And the guy that we are actually going to be playing with is a character that you guys are probably all familiar with if you watched any sort of movies in like the 90s. And the player that we're going to be playing with is Benny Rodriguez. Now, Benny Rodriguez, if you don't know, is actually the character from The Sandlot, who was like the nice older kid that kind of took the young nerdy kid under his wing and taught him how to play baseball. And then he actually ended up getting the ball and chasing or running away from the Beast as the Beast chased him at the end of the series, or the end of the show, I should say. So it was a good movie, of course. Everybody remembers The Sandlot. It's a classic, of course. And I wanted to play with somebody that everybody had kind of heard of. So there was like kind of like a little bit of a backstory. I don't know. It's just something that I like to do when I do my creative players. The first time that I did one on MLB 13, I actually did a Road to the Show with Rick the Wild Thing Vaughn, which was, of course, the pitcher from Major League. So it's kind of going along with that type of a theory anyway, wanting to get some sort of fun going here with a creative player, but somebody that's actually somebody that you've heard of, I guess. So Benny the Jet Rodriguez, shortstop, is our player that we're going to be using here. And his backup positions are the outfield positions, any of them, frankly. I mean, the theory was is that he could play any position, hypothetically. He's like the ultimate utility player. But in our series, we're going to try to play him at shortstop because it's a fun position to play on defense. It's one where you have to make good decisions. And I kind of think that Benny Rodriguez was perfect for that type of role. So that's what we're going to play.
Benny Rodriguez will step to the plate now as we're ready to get this one underway.
All right, so very first at bat for Benny Rodriguez in the showcase games. We're trying to get drafted here, so we're trying to do a couple different things. Obviously, we want to get hits. We don't want to make too many errors in the field. But more importantly, we have to make the right decisions, because that's really the thing that I understand that is important as far as getting scouted. So very first at bat, we line this thing out into left center field, and we are able to get a double.
Scouts love seeing a guy that can drive the ball with authority, and that's exactly what he did on that swing. I mean, when you can trot into second base with a stand-up double, you're pretty sure you put a good charge into the ball and got it out there into the deeper parts of the outfield. That has to feel good for him.
So there you go, guys, our very first hit in the showcase games. Now we're playing in the field. Again, shortstop Benny Rodriguez, and the ball goes right to us. Easy play, routine play, and we make it over there to first base. Feeling pretty good about that. I mean, obviously, it's harder than it looks to actually make the throws in this game, and I was just happy to not screw that one up, man. You know what I'm saying? I haven't had a whole lot of opportunity to practice playing this game yet, so unfortunately, there might be some plays where I make some mistakes in the field, whether it be decision-making or just not knowing how to throw the ball effectively or, you know, that kind of thing. And then, of course, batting practice. I mean, I guess I shouldn't say practice now in this game, because it's not really practice. This is kind of, I mean, this thing counts, of course. So I sometimes make bad decisions hitting as well. That time we did make contact on it. Unfortunately, the outfielder was able to track it down. It was a good at bat, though. We do get some points for it because of the solid contact, and we did take a couple of pitches as well. Now, back out in the field again and playing shortstop. Another easy play. And we're just going to sling this thing over to first base for an easy out. So again, 2 for 2 now. Feeling pretty good about how we're playing in the field. Again, another one here. And it's going to be right to us. Can we make the throw? It bounces, and the first baseman is unable to recover. That is going to go as an error for us, unfortunately. Not good.
Well, perhaps the pressure of the showcase and the scouts in attendance got to him on this play. I think he rushed himself on the throw, and that allows the runner to be safe.
Yeah, I kind of did rush myself, I think, on that throw. I held onto it for too long, and unfortunately, it did cost us with an error. Fortunately, our pitcher got out of it, so we were not in any trouble, didn't give up any runs because of it. Back up to bat now, and we are going to swing at a pitch outside. Normally, I'm able to hold off on the pitches outside. It's sometimes the inside ones that I have a big problem with. And there you see we are able to hold off on that one, the slider, I believe that was. Now, I'm going to expect that he's going to throw another slider down and away, and he actually does. And unfortunately, I'm stupid, and I thought it was going to be in the strike zone, so I decided to swing at it. Got out, unfortunately. We slide into first base just because, screw it. You kind of have to just attempt sometimes. So that's what I decided to do there. I know it's dumb to slide into first base, but whatever. Here, though, we are going to turn a beautiful double play in the field, so we kind of make up for the fact that we did not make a throw earlier in the game. Back out in the field here, 0-2 count, and it's an easy little grounder right to the shortstop, but we do have to make a running throw, and we are able to make it. So I was a little bit nervous when I saw that running animation. Fortunately, we did make the play, and but then it was kind of weird. They took us out in the seventh inning for some reason. They pinch hit for us. Obviously, I didn't have two good at-bats in a row, but I did double in my first at-bat, so I kind of figured that they would let me stay in. Fortunately, we did get the win, so it wasn't a big deal. Now we get a message. Great showing out there today. The scouts were impressed by your presence on the field, and your instincts really opened some eyes. Your draft stock is definitely on the rise, so that's good. We're feeling pretty good about the way that we played in the first game. Now on to game number two. Again, currently 1-for-3 with a double, so not a great batting average. I mean, I guess it's only one game, so a very small sample size. A 333, obviously, if you had that over the course of a season, would be amazing, but for one game, it is just, you know, it's a one-hit type of thing. But we are going to turn a double play to start this game, so feeling pretty good about how we're playing in the outfield, or I shouldn't say outfield, in the infield, but, you know, we definitely need to step up in the hitting game here. So let's get into it, see what we can do here in this first at-bat. Thinking that he's probably going to try and pitch low, and unfortunately went straight over the middle kind of, and we do foul one off. Very difficult to actually hit those curveballs in this game. I don't know what it is. I just cannot hit freaking curveballs in this game. We do hold off on the second pitch though, a high and tight fastball. Let's see what he pitches here in the third pitch, and it's a meatball right down the middle. Oh, we should have been able to crush that thing. We do foul it off, though. At least we didn't take a strike on it. And guys, I want you to let me know in the comments section below. Do you want to see every single pitch of every at-bat? Or what do you think as far as that goes? Because some of these really take long, especially if you have a good batter's eye. And hopefully I'll be able to improve as time goes on in that aspect of things. But let me know in the comments section below what you think of that. And we are going to smack this thing out, a liner to the outfield, unfortunately. The fielder does come up with it. It was a decent at bat though, so we do get some points because of the solid contact and the fact that it was a five pitch at bat. Five pitch at bat isn't really anything special, but it really is more difficult than you would think as we make a play out here in the field. So we do get the out there, but again, guys, it actually is, if you've never played this baseball game before, it's a lot more difficult to hold off on pitches than you would think. You just want to smack every single pitch. Like, if they throw it right down the middle like that, you have to swing. It's almost impossible not to swing, even if that's not the pitch that you're looking for. It's just so very, very difficult. And we're down 0-1 already in the count here.
Now the pitch. And here's a pitch inside, and that got him.
Well, most of the time, you don't mind a harmless beanball because it can really help your team by getting guys on base. But in this situation, you're wanting to show off your stuff. Show these scouts here what you can do with the bat.
So a hit by pitch is obviously not what we were hoping for. We do want to get a hit, but at the same time, though, it did let us get on base. So it's not really the end of the world. Decent enough anyway. So now we're in a good position here. Runners on first and second base. We just need to make contact here to potentially get a run home. And we do line this thing out to the outfield, but unfortunately, it wasn't enough power behind it. So we do load the bags here, but unfortunately, we did not get an RBI there. Decent play, decent hit there, though, anyway. Next at bat here now in the bottom of the sixth. We're up 8-2. This should be an easy win for us. Runner at first base, and we're just going to try and get him over into scoring position here with one out. That's the big goal here on this at bat. So looking to try and get a hit here of some sort. I mean, if we get hit by another pitch, that would be totally fine as well. Just get a guy into scoring position. But it's nice here. We're trying to take as many pitches as we can. This one is a 2-0 pitch. So that one went high. I'm actually better at holding off on the high pitches than I am the low pitches for some reason. Maybe other people are the same way. I'm not exactly sure why I'm better at that than I am on the low pitches. But it's definitely something that I need to work on as a player, because it's so difficult for me for some reason to lay off on those low pitches. That one kind of was in the strike zone, kind of not. It was outside. I probably could have taken that, and it could have been a ball. It could have been called a ball, because this game isn't exactly perfect with the way that it renders the hitbox. I guess it kind of makes sense, actually. It goes along with kind of how the umpires call things in real life. Sometimes they call things that are in the strike box a ball, and vice versa. It just kind of depends on the individual umpire, and they kind of try to replicate that in this game, as you see us foul off yet another pitch. So this is a long at bat here, and again, guys, if you want to see every single pitch of the at bat, I can definitely do that for you going forward, but I want to hear what you guys have to say about it. We could just do like the important pitches or the money pitches, whether it be I get struck out or I get a hit, or you know, whatever the case might be. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section below, because I don't want to bore you with all these long at bats unless it's something that you're very interested in, because it's sometimes difficult to actually talk over it as well. It's hard to really talk when they're just slowly pitching the ball and you're really not getting anything going, whether it be in the strikeout area or in the hit area. But we do load this thing up to a full count. Again, trying my best just to take pitches here. That time, though, he left it over the plate. I attempted to hit that thing as deep as I could, but damn, we just couldn't get a hit. Fortunately, though, because it was an 8-pitch at bat, we still did get good points. So even the fact that we didn't get a hit there ended up being a good thing for us, because we are going to be able to improve our draft stock just by showing that we're able to take balls, which is, you know, something that other people in this game are typically not very good at. Yikes, though. Next at bat, we just ground right into a double play. Nearly got there. If we had a little bit more speed, we probably could have made it to first base there. So two bad at bats in terms of not getting a hit, but one of them we did load up the full count at least. The second time, though, it was just terrible. A freaking grounder for an easy double play. This time, though, we are going to make a nice play in the field. And that pretty much ended the game. We are going to go 1-for-3. It says 1-for-4, but again, we got that hit by pitch. So decent at bats for us. Way to improve your draft stock. You shut off all your skills last game, so try to keep that momentum going. This is our last chance here, guys, by the way. This is the final showcase game. Can we have a decent game here? Really, all that I want to do is make sure that I get a hit in this game and don't really get a ton of errors. That's pretty much the goal here. So that's what we're looking for. A 286 average so far. Decent, not spectacular. We definitely need to get a hit in this game to make sure that we improve that a little bit. So first pitch of the game here, down and away. Easy to hold off on that one, even though it's a 96 mile per hour pitch. Not difficult to hold off when they throw it that far under the strike zone. Now the second one here, I did call for that pitch. I thought for sure that he would go to the curveball at some point. So we're up 2-0 in the count. Again, guys, just making sure that we take as many pitches as we can in terms of the ball. We do not want to throw any pitches away, but we don't want to make sure that we're swinging at any bad pitches in this one. That last pitch, though, was up and in, and for some reason I swung at it anyway. That one probably would have been a strike, so I had to kind of swing at that one. 2-2 count now, and the pitcher has really kind of worked his way back from being in a bad situation to being ahead in the count now, and I'm starting to take some foul balls here, just trying to make sure that I don't strike out here if I can. I mean, really, striking out's the worst thing that you can do. At least if I take some pitches here and don't, you know, get an out easily, it's not so bad, because I'm still improving my draft stock by being able to be in there for long at-bats. So this is, again, a 7-pitch at-bat here, so not bad overall. It's actually more difficult than you would think to even get to 7 pitches in this game. But we are going to hit this thing out to the outfield, pretty much the warning track there. Decent contact on it, so, and again, that 7-pitch at-bat isn't too bad, so even though we did get an out there, it wasn't the end of the world. We are able to slightly improve our draft stock at least. As you can see there, guys, at the top of your screen, I actually do have a dynamic hitting thing and a difficulty slider thing. I don't even know what the hell you call it in this game, but it goes up and down as you actually play better or worse. So right there, we got a hit. So it's going to go up a little bit in terms of being a little bit more difficult for our next at bat. It kind of tries to figure out how good you are at the game and then adjust the sliders to make it as competitive as possible. So I actually really like that about this game. That's something that you can do to kind of make it more fun. Even if you're not very good at the game, you know, it can still keep it low enough for you that you're able to do decent enough and not be just a complete piece of crap. So third at bat here, unfortunately, swinging at a pitch in the dirt. I'm definitely trying to pound one out for a home run, but it's just not working out for us here. Now, I did call this pitch down and away, and I'm going to swing at it. I thought for sure that because I called it that we would actually be able to make contact on it, but we do strike out for our final at bat, and I'm just going to kind of spoil it a little bit there, but we do make a play in the outfield here. I am going to get, once again, pinch hit, but I hope you guys enjoyed the showcase. Our next thing that we show in this series will be the draft. So I need some luck, guys. Wish me some luck in the comment section on being drafted to a good team. Hope you guys enjoyed the series. If you did, be sure to hit that like button. Subscribe if you're new, and I'll talk to you guys again soon.